Hey guys, it's me, Maddie, again, just doing my own trailer analysis of Resident Evil Retribution. And let's start.
Technology is changing our world.
My name is John, and this is my world.
Okay, right here we can see, obviously, a man in Times Square holding a Sony Ericsson phone. Well, which obviously is probably going to be one of the places where Resident Evil is going to take place. Sorry, I sound like I have a lisp, or probably can't understand me, but, let's go to the next person.
Making what was once impossible.
My name is Anna, and this is my world.
Possible.
Crap. Okay, it's a woman in Moscow, Russia, holding a PS Vita, or Vita.
My name is Yumiko, and this is my world.
Okay, we have a woman from Japan, obviously. That sounded racist, but we have a woman in Tokyo, Japan, holding a Sony MP3 player. And we already know Japan is zombified, as we saw in the last film, Resident Evil Afterlife. So we know that she's dead.
With technology advancing so rapidly today.
My name is Fang, and this is my world.
God, I'm a girl. All the time, we probably know he's dead.
What our world will look like tomorrow.
Welcome to Resident Evil. Okay, right here, we see Washington, D.C. with the Washington Monument in the lower right-hand corner. And all the lights that you see that are out of focus are small fires, and the big light in the middle is the White House being attacked by the flying monsters from Resident Evil 5. Okay, so this obviously has to take place in the past, because, see, she is surrounded by military people, not Umbrella people that are trying to kill her, and she's wearing the all-black leather that's signature for Umbrella, and with the Umbrella logo right there.
My name is Alice, and this is my world.
Okay, so what I'm thinking, though, is that this clip was only made for the trailer, and I don't think this will be in it. Okay, so right here, this is taken out of the game. It is a Rolls Royce instead of a Humvee being chased what seems to be a giant licker. Hold on, let me back that up a little. Okay, we're obviously somewhere cold. And the first guy on the left seems to be Luther West. The second guy on the left seems to be Leon Kennedy. The last two, I have no idea who they are. Maybe the one in the hat is Mila Jovovich. Okay, so right here we see Mila, or Alice, holding a child. Which may be hers, I'm not sure. But this seems to take place before the first movie. Because she has the yellow hair. And that is a 2000... No, this is a early 2000s Impala police car, which, you know, you don't see that many anymore. And then one of these Umbrella helicopter plane things. Japan again. Ada Wong from the Resident Evil game series, as you may know, but she is in a suburban area. Do you see that? So we know some of this takes place in suburbia, but this is during the outbreak, because see, that's a fresh body, and it's all bright and happy and hunky-dory outside. And then, is that a swing set? Right. No, see, it's a cop car right there, so this has to be new. Either that or a foreign country. Because, see, right now they're in a house with Mila Jovovich. You see, I am so confused because I have no idea when this takes place. Oh, this is obviously right after Afterlife because she has the outfit with the two double barrel shotguns and umbrella people falling out of the sky. Oh, I gotta get me one of those. She just bitch slaps on with that chain. Wait, who was behind her? Oh, those are zombies. But see, I have no idea when this takes place, because see, that is an umbrella logo on her chest. You can see a little bit of the red right above her hand. Because see, I mean, really, when does this take place? And that is a fresh zombie wearing normal clothes. So you see right from the get-go, from the trailer, I see a lot of plot holes. Like, just from the trailer alone. And see, I'm not dissing Resident Evil, but I don't know, because, like they say, Rain is supposed to come back, played by Michelle Rodriguez, which I don't get how they got her DNA since they nuked Raccoon City, and the Hive is right under Raccoon City, and that's where her body is. And, you see, like, I have no idea, because, like, just from the trailer alone, it confuses the crap out of me. And I don't know, because I mean, it shows her wearing an umbrella uniform, obviously. So maybe she was captured by Sienna Guillory or Jill Valentine and had the bug on her. And maybe she was brainwashed into working for Umbrella for a while. And then she, you know, got her memory back again. I don't know, I'm overthinking this, but it's just really bugging me. Comment below and tell me what you think.